Hi you guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm doing a review and demo and a test of this IT Cosmetics Bye Bye Under Eye Concealer. So in this video I'll be looking at how much this concealer actually covers up, as well as doing updates throughout the day to see how it's lasting, and also looking at the finish of this concealer, whether or not it's gonna cake underneath your eyes or look beautiful for the entire day. So if you guys are curious to see what this concealer is all about and whether or not it is worth all of the hype, then continue watching. But not before I ask you to subscribe to my channel if you like beauty and style, and also to give this video a thumbs up to support my channel. So with that being said, let's jump into the video and I hope you guys enjoy it. So I want to give you guys a quick info on this Bye Bye Under Eye Concealer, just so you know what this concealer is all about and what the claims are. First of all, it is $24 for the full size. I believe there is a small travel size, so if you want to try it out, you can do so with the smaller size, but the bigger size is better value for your money, and it is $24 for 8 milliliters or 0.28 ounces. So I've originally purchased the light color and that was way too light, and I'm not a really dark person. Like, I'm pretty pale. I have a little bit of fake tan going on, but even if I don't have a fake tan, I'm paler, and the light color was just way too light. So the color that I have and I'll be working with today is called medium tan. This is the warm medium. I believe medium, just regular medium, is the most popular color they have, but for me it seemed like it was a little bit too pink for my skin tone, which has a lot of yellow undertones to it. So I went with the medium tan, which had a little bit more yellow undertones to it. If you're not sure which color to go for between the light and the medium, or if you're kind of like my general skin tone, then I would suggest going for either the medium or the medium tan. Don't go for the light. I know everybody wants that beautiful bright under eyes, but the light color is just too light, trust me. So the claims of this concealer are it covers everything without creasing or cracking. So you basically get full coverage with a beautiful finish that will last all day because it doesn't crack or crease. On the packaging, it says that it's full coverage anti-aging waterproof concealer, which, I mean, to me it's like, yes please, I want that, where can I get it? And then it has some interesting ingredients in it as well, including anti-aging peptides, vitamins, antioxidants, hydrolyzed collagen, and hyaluronic acid. Those ingredients, as far as I can understand, are trying to hydrate and kind of replenish your skin, which is great for under eyes because your under eyes are likely to be on the drier side. You know, that's the area without any oil glands. It's really thin skin, so it's likely to get irritated and dried out very easily. So it's great that this is trying to be moisturizing. Now, I looked at the ingredients list and I'm not a chemist and I'm not pretending to be, but those ingredients are, I think, a little bit further down in the list. I love the concept of wearing makeup that's actually good for your skin, but I wouldn't say that this is going to replace your skincare routine. But I like the fact that this concealer is trying to not only conceal your eyes or conceal your under eyes, but also help your under eye area look beautiful when you take this concealer off. So I like that a lot. All right, so with that being said, let's jump into the application process and see how this works. Okay, you guys, so I don't have any makeup on except for a little bit of foundation, which I made sure to not apply around my eyes to be able to really see how much this concealer alone can cover so that the foundation does not mess with our test. I'm gonna take a little bit on my finger, and this is a squeezable tube, which some of you might like that, some of you might not like that, depending on what you prefer. I'm gonna take a little bit of this on my finger, and it does take a little bit of time to squeeze the concealer out. It's kind of like a thicker consistency, so it doesn't want to squeeze out on its own without a good push. This is how much I'm using on my finger, the tiniest amount. It is a thicker consistency, almost like creamy consistency that's been liquefied to be able to put into a tube. It does feel very, very creamy and rich, which honestly makes me a little bit nervous because creamy concealers tend to slip and slide and just they don't look good on me. That's not my type of concealer, but this does say it's not supposed to crease or crack, so fingers crossed. Anyway, I don't think it has a smell. It smells like nothing, which I think it's a good thing. I mean, I guess it's not as good as smelling like chocolate or candy, but it doesn't have a bad smell or anything like that. All right, so this is the before and the after or side-by-side comparison. This side does not have anything on it, foundation but no concealer, and this side has the concealer on it. Again, I took the tiniest amount. It is thick, it is very pigmented, so you don't need much, which is good news because it's kind of more on the expensive side of things. It's $24 for a tube. Not super expensive, but obviously not cheap, and if you don't have to use a lot, that means it's gonna last you for a long time, and that's always a good thing. I don't have have the darkest circles. Sometimes I do, sometimes I don't. Today is kind of one of those days where I don't have the darkest of circles, but I definitely have enough darkness there for me to want to apply concealer. And it covered everything up like magic. Besides being high coverage, it's also light reflective. It's very dewy, so you can see how the light just shines back at you guys. I'm blinding you with my under eyes. Wow, the reflectiveness of this concealer is just like, phew. That being said, I am going to set this concealer with powder, so we're gonna have to see how it's gonna perform. Because if its strongest point is reflection, powder might kind of mess that up. Okay, so as far as the best application method, I've always been doing my finger. I feel like that's the best way to apply something so creamy. But I did just try doing the sponge. The sponge, I feel like, doesn't spread it well enough, and it also, because this is so thick and creamy, your sponge is gonna get kind of dirty and then you're gonna have a hard time cleaning it. And then the second way of doing it is using a brush, which I'm not really a big fan of applying concealers with a brush. If you are, this could probably work, but again, you're gonna have to kind of move it around. And again, I'm not a big fan of buffing my makeup because I do have dry patches on my skin, and I feel like sometimes moving and buffing makeup around can actually lift some of the dryness and make your skin look even more scaly, even more dry, and even more patchy. And yes, I do have oily skin, but I also use a lot of acne medication, so my skin is kind of like an enigma where I have oily skin but then it's also dry, so it's kind of like the worst of both worlds. But I feel like if you had to pick between using a makeup sponge or a brush, if you don't want to use your fingers, then I would choose a brush, I think. And then makeup sponge would be the last thing. I'm a huge fan of applying concealer with a makeup sponge. That's what I do on a daily basis for most concealers, but I think this is just a little bit too thick. Now the fun part. Powder. I'm going to be using my trusty Laura Mercier translucent setting powder, which I'm actually running low on, and I'm probably going to have to buy it again. And if you guys use it, you know it's expensive, and I'm not looking forward to repurchasing it, but I kind of can't live without it. I'm going to take some of this powder on the brush, and let's see. This is the moment of truth. Alright you guys, so this is concealer and powder. It's not the most skin-like finish. It's not caking necessarily, but you can see there's bulkiness and thickness and product underneath the eye, and it's not something I like. I liked it better without the powder, but I think that for most days I will be wearing powder, so you know, I wanted to be true to how I would wear it and probably how you guys would wear it too. I am back with the rest of my makeup. I feel a little bit more alive, a little bit more tan, because my face is now matching the rest of my body. My face doesn't have fake tan, my body does, so you know, a little bronzer was needed. Anyway, I'm here to do my little update. It's been about an hour. I know it took me an hour to kind of get my stuff together and do my makeup and come back, so it's kind of a mini update on what's going on. And I'm also going to be doing updates throughout the day and just kind of showing you what's going on with this concealer, and really mainly seeing how it's lasting, whether it's creasing, whether it's crumbling up or cracking, because supposedly this concealer doesn't do any of that, and I just want to kind of see what's going on. So this is my makeup, this is how it's looking as far as the concealer. I'm gonna zoom you guys in to show you what's going on up close and personal, because you know, we're friends. I'm more than happy to show you my pimples and acne and gosh knows what, a lot of stuff. You know, I show you guys everything, all the grossness, all the things that I don't want anybody else to see, but you guys are welcome to see all that. All right, friends, you are up close and personal with me now. The coverage is still there, but the one thing I will say is that whole texture thing that I was talking about earlier is, it's not getting any better. Actually, it might be getting a little bit worse even. I'm already starting to see a little bit of creasing. There's starting to be a little bit of product collecting right in the actual fold, the actual crease, which isn't horrible because again, if I just look at you and I don't try to stretch my eye out, which you wouldn't be doing on a daily basis when you're talking to people, nobody's actually gonna see that buildup, but I know it's there. I guess the way I would look at it is the coverage is great. I love the coverage, but the consistency of the product and the finish is not my favorite so far. All of the creamy concealers on me personally just tended to do exactly this, except this is actually probably one of the best creamy concealers that I've tried. So stay tuned and I'll be back with an update of this Bye Bye Under Eye Concealer, and we'll see what's going on underneath my eyes. I am back with my final update after about 5.5 hours of wearing this Bye Bye Under Eye Concealer, and I'm here to tell you what I think and basically show you what has been going on. Before I get too far into my speech, I want to zoom you guys in to show you what is going on so you can see for yourself. So it is creasing. It kind of stopped creasing after the initial crease. Texture thing and the finish is not something I'm totally crazy about, unfortunately. And again, this is my experience. Maybe that's not going to happen to you per se, but for me, I am dealing with some creasing and just overall like heavy cakey feel. The claim here was that it wasn't going to crease or crack or anything like that. It's not cracking, but it is creasing on me. So I'm kind of trying to figure out what I want to say here, because on the one hand, I do like the fact that it is extremely high coverage. I like the reflectiveness of it if you don't apply any powder. But on the other hand, I just don't love the finish of it, and not the finish so much as how it sits on the skin. Yeah, again, if you want to try it, I think it's not a bad product for, especially for a creamy concealer, if that's the kind of concealer you want. It does cover dark circles really, really well. But if you're going to want to try this, don't apply a lot of powder. And here's why. I think that before applying powder, you do have that reflectiveness underneath your eyes, which helps to brighten up your under eye area and get rid of dark circles. But also, two things. You are less likely to have cakiness if you don't apply a lot of powder or any at all. And then you also could just go back and smooth things out if creasing starts to happen for you. For me, it happened, and I tried to go in and kind of smooth everything out, but because of the powder, it really wasn't working that well. It honestly just depends on kind of what you want and what you like. I am probably going to reach for it when my dark circles are really bad. But if my dark circles aren't that bad, then I'm probably gonna skip this and go for something a little bit lighter, a little bit less producty. I like this product enough to see what else they have. I'm actually really curious to try Your Skin But Better CC Cream with SPF 50. I'm on their website now and I'm looking at the things that they sell that are really popular, and also the powder. I'm really curious to try their powder. I don't know if you guys have tried any of those products or have any other ones that you love, but let me know in the comment section down below because I'm curious. Thanks so much for sticking around with me. I hope you're still watching. If you are, then I just want to give you a big hug for sticking around and supporting me. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up before you go. Make sure to subscribe to my channel if you like beauty and fashion videos, because I make them weekly. And I will see you in the next video, hopefully. Bye.